Hello friends, welcome to my channel Local Guy. In today's video, I am going to review the Mi Home Security 360 degree camera after using it for 2 years and still using it without any problem. Recently, I bought the same new Mi Home Security 360 degree camera because I am very much satisfied with its performance, so decided to review it. Mi Security camera is the best budget home security camera. No other wireless home security camera offers feature which this camera provides. In this video, I will talk about how to install the camera, its features, and also suggest where to place the camera. This camera also supports NAS storage, and one thing many people don't know, you can also live view the camera on a desktop computer or laptop without using any Android emulator like BlueStack and all. There is a Windows PC software for Mi Security camera. So watch this video till the end. So here is the new Mi Home Security camera. It comes with AI motion detection alert, 1080 pixels HD video quality, infrared night vision and talkback features. The price range of the camera is between 2700 to 2900 Indian rupees. The camera comes with nice packaging. Let's open it. In the box you can find instruction manual, 7 feet long USB power cable, power adapter and ceiling mount. And here is the camera which is wrapped in the plastic bag. It has inbuilt microphone and speaker for talkback functionality. Below you can find the reset button and USB port. You can hang the camera upside down by just twisting the camera inside the ceiling mount slot. Let's power the camera. Here I am using power bank to power the camera. Camera starts rotating and you can hear scan QR code for pairing the device waiting for connection.
Scan QR code to pair the device. Waiting for connection.
Let's open Mi Home app and start pairing the device. Mi Home will prompt to turn on the Bluetooth to detect the camera. Here Mi Home has already detected the camera. Let's tap on it and select the Wi-Fi network to pair the camera. New QR code will be generated. You have to show this QR code to the camera. You will hear the prompt.
QR code scanned successfully. Connecting. Please wait. Connection to Wi-Fi completed. Pairing to account completed. Device online.
I am placing the camera in the living room. You can rename the device also. Camera pairing is completed and here is the live view of the camera which is in HD 1080 pixels quality. I have another camera which I mounted upside down at the entrance of my home. You can mount this camera outdoors too, but make sure that you don't place it under direct sunlight cause it will damage the camera's lens. This camera is not waterproof, so be careful while mounting outdoors. I have mounted the camera under the outer ceiling of my home entrance, so it's far away from direct sunlight and it's also safe from water during monsoon season. I have mounted the camera at this place and since then never touched it for the last 2 years, so this camera has been tested during all the 3 seasons, summer, monsoon, winter, so mount the camera at the right place for durability and never face any problem. I have connected the power directly to the mains without any on-off switch, so nobody can switch off the camera. So here is the live view of my home entrance. You can pan left, right, up, down using this PTZ button and also zoom, just double tap on the screen. Here is the mic button for the talkback function. Using it, you can talk with the person at the entrance. There is also an inbuilt mic in camera itself, so the person at the entrance is able to communicate with you and it's a great feature. You can capture the photo by clicking on camera button. The photo will be stored in camera album. The camera records the video in memory card, but you can also record the video in your phone using on-screen video camera button. You can put the camera into sleep mode, so no video will be recorded during sleep time. By default, the camera is in mute mode, you can unmute it. You can also lower the view quality using this button. You can also watch the video in landscape or full screen mode, all control buttons available on full screen mode also. You can playback the video, just tap on the playback button and move the cursor to a particular time to watch the recorded video. You can increase the speed of the playback video to 2x, 4x and 16x. You can also browse the video by date and time. Camera stores the video of 1 minute chunk, so 1 hour video will be splitted into 60 files each of 1 minute. Under surveillance, you can watch all trigger events. You can also filter the events to motion detected or person detected. On the camera settings, you can turn the status light on or off. Status light is the small LED light on the camera. During night, turn it off and nobody can notice the camera. Data usage warning. If turned on, then video starts playing automatically on Wi-Fi, but on mobile data, you have to tap on play button to start viewing the live stream. Sleep settings. You can schedule the sleep settings so the camera will not record during that time. Under image settings, you can turn on or off timestamp on video, lens distortion correction. Wide dynamic range will improve the video quality when video is overexposed or underexposed. If camera is mounted upside down, you can rotate the image. Night vision settings. Camera automatically turns on night vision when it detects low light. You can manually turn it on or off also. Camera calibration. Camera will calibrate itself by rotating horizontally and vertically. Pop-up window. You can pop up the live stream on screen so you can do multitasking. You can reboot device by tapping on reboot button. Under home monitoring, turn on home surveillance assistant. You can set the surveillance period like 24 hours, day surveillance, night surveillance, or can customize surveillance time. You can set the sensitivity high or low. On high sensitivity, it will detect the mosquito's motion too. Alarm interval. You can set it to 3, 5, 10 or 30 minutes. Detection push notification will send the notification on your phone. You can filter the event notification whether it's motion or person. You have to insert a micro SD card in the slot. Just pan the camera all the way to up and you can find the micro SD card slot. You have to use high speed memory card like class 10, U1 or U3. If you use another class or low speed card, then you will find difficulty while playback the recorded video, sometimes no memory card or problem with SD card error and sometimes camera hangs too. Under the app, it says the camera supports up to 32GB, but actually it supports up to 64GB. Using 64GB storage, you can store up to 7 to 8 days of audio video recording in HD 1080 pixels quality. On the manage storage, you can check the SD card status. You can also store the camera videos in NAS. Just tap on it, enter username and password of NAS. Here I am using my Windows computer share folder as NAS and choose the folder where you want to save the recordings. You can pause the NAS video storage. You can set the video length settings to 1 week, 1 month, 3 month, 6 month, 12 month. Time interval between uploads live 1 hour, 1 day. Under data storage settings, you can change the folder location or NAS. You can delete the NAS storage also. Under the album, you can browse the video or photos that you have marked save permanently. Under automation, you can trigger the event using if and then statements. You can share the video to other family members too, so they are also able to watch or monitor live view of the camera. Under general settings, you can change the device name, manage location, can update firmware. You can secure the device by setting the password to view the device. Under network info, you can see the Wi-Fi network details. To avoid disconnection, keep the camera closer to the Wi-Fi router for strong signal strength. You can set the time zone. You can create a shortcut on home screen. One thing many people don't know is that you can also watch the live view of the camera on a desktop PC or laptop too. For that, I have made a separate video. Please watch it. Link is given in the description and above on I button. Some facts about Xiaomi Mi Home Security 360 degree Wi-Fi camera. The design of the camera is attractive. Camera consumes only 5 watt of power. Camera resolution is 2 megapixels. Focal length is 3.9 mm and optical zoom is 2x. Camera viewing angle is 110 degree. You can rotate the camera full 360 degree. Camera weighs only 240 grams. You need a Wi-Fi router to connect with the camera. Hotspot will not work. Without the internet, you can't access the camera through the app. Camera can record the video without internet too. Not just on Wi-Fi, you can view the camera from any location or from any part of the world. You can watch the live view of the camera on desktop PC or laptop too. It sends intruder alert via push notification on mobile. On high sensitivity, it sends the push notification even mosquito's motion is detected. You need continuous power supply to operate this camera. There is no battery backup. If there is a power outage, the camera will start recording again and also connect to the Wi-Fi as soon as power comes back. When memory card storage is full, you don't need to delete the previous videos manually. The camera deletes the oldest video automatically to free up the storage. You can set up the external NAS storage. There is no cloud storage option. Camera storage video is not encrypted, so anybody can view the videos using memory card. The inbuilt speaker audio is not loud and clear. Night vision quality is good at this price range. Camera can see up to 30 feet in night vision. Camera operates on Wi-Fi 2.4 GHz and supports IEEE BGN standard. Camera does not support Wi-Fi 5 GHz. Put the camera closer to the Wi-Fi router to avoid frequent disconnection. Minimum signal strength RSSI should be -70 dBm. You can pair the camera to the Google Assistant and Alexa. If you are living in a small house or in an apartment or own a shop, you can install it at the entrance of your home or office. You can keep an eye on kids when you are not at home. I recommend this camera because instead of buying a full CCTV setup, which is costly, this is a budget camera everyone can afford. So buy it now. The link is given below in the description. Thanks for watching. If you have any query, please ask in the comments. Like and share the video and don't forget to subscribe. Goodbye. Have a nice day.